And welcome back to my channel Physio Trends. This is me Physio Prem Shah, and this video I am going to explain you all different types of SLR and in SLR how to diagnose different conditions. So let's first begin with another name for SLR test. SLR basically means that straight leg raise test. It is also known as Lessigue test. So if it comes to you that somebody asks you about the Lessigue test, don't get confused. It is same as SLR test. Now to begin with the test, first of all, patient's position is in supine lying position. Therapist is at one side of the patient, whichever the side you want to check first. Remember that in any special test in physiotherapy, first we check on the normal side and then we go on the abnormal side. So let's suppose that this side is abnormal, this is normal. I have checked for the normal side and now I am going for the abnormal side. First thing what I am going to do is I am just going to lift the patient's leg up till the patient is complaining of increasing in the symptoms. Now let's just imagine if patient complains of pain in initial range, which is 0 to 30 degrees of range of motion, then what can be the main complaint? In such cases, most of the time there is a structural damage to the vertebral column. For example, there can be listhesis, there can be any fracture around the spinal cord or vertebral column, or there can be any other structural changes, like for example more of the anterior pelvic tilt or more of the posterior pelvic tilt, because of which patient will have pain in the initial 30 degree of SLR. Now let's suppose that patient is not complaining of pain in initial 30, but patient is complaining of pain between 30 to 60 degree of range of motion, then that pain and increasing of symptom is mainly because of the symptoms related to the disc prolapse. So whenever the neural symptoms are present, patient complains of tingling, numbness in this range after 30 to 60, that is considered to be there because of disc prolapse. Now in this also two differential diagnoses we can make. If it is in the younger population, 35 to 45, we consider disc prolapse. If it is after 60 age of patient, mostly it is because of spinal stenosis. Now how spinal stenosis is different from the disc prolapse? So spinal stenosis is a degenerative condition because of which there is a narrowing of the neural foramen, and because of that patient is having tingling numbness, and that you will notice in more than one vertebral column spaces. So it is not necessary that it is only present between L4, L5. It can be present between L2, L3, L3, L4, L4, L5, but that mostly happens after the age of 60. Now let's say if patient is not complaining of pain till 60, but when you go from 60 to 90, patient complains of extra pain. So that, my dear friends, normally is because of muscle tissue stretch, okay? Normally hamstring tightness or back muscle tightness or spasm can cause this kind of pain if patient complains after 60 degrees of SLR. So this is how we can clearly diagnose a patient for back pain condition using just one test, Lessigue test or SLR test. Now in SLR also, if you just want to find out that which exact nerve is getting impinged, so for that we can perform SLR 1, 2 and 3. SLR 1 is performed to find out problems with the tibial nerve. For that we will perform the SLR. Along with that, we are going to perform the eversion, and along with that we are going to go with the dorsiflexion. So for tibial nerve, eversion and dorsiflexion. If patient complains of pain, increasing of symptoms, that means the test is positive only for tibial nerve. Next one, SLR 2 is for your sural nerve. If patient has complaints with the sural nerve, you will notice that you perform the SLR. Along with that, instead of eversion, go with the inversion and then go for dorsiflexion. If symptoms are aggravated, that means it is because of something wrong with the sural nerve. And the third one is common peroneal nerve. So in common peroneal nerve, if patient is having problems, that means you perform the SLR. Along with that, you perform inversion as well as plantar flexion and check out if the symptoms are increasing or exaggerated. So now, my dear friends, you will be wondering that how to remember this very nicely. So for that, I have a mnemonic for you. You just have to remember TED, SID and PIP. Okay, so TED means tibial nerve, eversion and dorsiflexion. SID means sural nerve, inversion and dorsiflexion. And PIP means peroneal nerve inversion and plantar flexion. So this is the way you can easily remember this SLR 1, 2, 3 and diagnose your patient for the back pain condition. If you still have any doubts about the Lesigue test, SLR test, do let me know in the comment section. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Physio Trends.